Big boy Mico is a prime example of a young adult orangutan. The rippling muscles, the extraordinary upper body strength. He's really too big to be here in such close proximity to humans, especially as he has brains as well as brawn.
Mico's such a clever orangutan. You have to be constantly alert to what he's up to. When there were some builders in, Mico made a complete mess of all this wood, banged it a little. All things that they would have been watching those builders do and copying it.
This kind of behaviour may be adorable when the orangutans are little, but 14-year-old Mico is now 7 times stronger than the strongest male ranger.
A smack from something the size of him could break an arm, could break a leg. He's a teenager growing up with lots of feelings and lots of vibes going on in his own body. He's becoming a man.
After graduating from forest school 7 years ago, Mico was released into the jungle surrounding Sepilok. But he's never fully made the break.
No, Mico!
Now, for his own good, his hand needs to be forced.
Within a rehabilitation centre, these animals will have picked up a lot of human behaviours along the way, and it makes it even more of a struggle and a more difficult process to get them to express the behaviours of wild orangutans so that they can be released and survive out in the wild at the end.
Mico's best hope of becoming truly wild is being taken somewhere far enough away from civilization that he won't be tempted to return. But as grown up as Mico looks, is he really man enough to take on life in the wild? 14-year-old Mico is facing a real test of his manhood. Release into one of Borneo's last protected wildernesses.
It's a really big day for Mico today because he's actually off to Tabin. So he's got a really long journey ahead of him. James, our primatologist, is here taking great care of him, making sure he's reassured and comforted and is comfortable getting into the transferring crate that will take him down to Tabin today.
You don't want to let him go because you know it's going to be hard for him, but at the same time, you're so proud to see them go.
Now all that's standing between Mico and his new home is 200 kilometres of Bornean road.
It's quite emotional to see him going off to start the rest of his life. He's got all the attributes he needs to be fully wild.
It's a really big challenge for every orangutan to be moved into a new forested environment. The food species are different, different predators, different threats. It's a really massive thing for them to overcome.
Like humans, the impact of a new environment can be very unsettling for an orangutan. Although there's no way of knowing how Mico will cope mentally when he's faced with life in Tabin, physically at least, he should have no trouble.
For people, the bones in our fingers are quite straight. In orangutans, they're naturally curved, which means that when an orangutan is holding onto a branch, they're not having to really use any energy to do so in terms of their muscle. Orangutans' feet are essentially another pair of hands with an opposable big toe.
Orangutans are totally ambidextrous and they can do as much with their feet as they can with their hands. They just go from tree to tree, swinging the tree over and gripping with whichever limb is nearest. Clever boy!
Unlike humans, orangutans have longer arms than legs, and an adult will have an arm span of up to 2 metres.
Oh, thank you.
All of these special anatomical adaptations mean Mico is perfectly designed for life in the jungle. Now he just needs to put everything he's learned at forest school into practice.
We're going to be driving through palm oil plantations for more or less 1 more hour, and then we'll be entering Tabin Wildlife Reserve, which will be Mico's new home.
Tabin is the perfect place. It's so remote. It is a beautiful, beautiful, diverse area, and it's protected.
Finally, the team arrive at the release point, quite literally at the end of the road, over 10 kilometres away from the nearest human habitation. It's a world away from what Mico's used to. From here on in, Mico will have to rely on the skills he learned at Sepilok to survive. But he has a better chance than most, with a dedicated team monitoring his every move.
To watch nature play out in front of us is beautiful. Those are the golden moments. That's why we're here.
Based on what we saw this morning and what we already know from Mico, we're really optimistic about his chances.